as the Earthship Australia dude, I suppose part of the things, one of the things that I related to was the scenes with the older guy played by Michael Caine, the character of Jasper. He seemed to be outside of this urban environment, and in the beginning of the film they see him drive up to this deserted country road, and they sort of took away some brush and there was like a hidden driveway, and that was the access to his property. But he was obviously growing crops, whether it was marijuana or something. Anyway, but the point is, it was things that he could trade, and and he was able to sustain a lifestyle and outside all the horrors of that.
Kind of isolate himself.
That's right. So it was like an oasis, wasn't it? You had the grey sort of urban environment, and then you had this place that Jasper had created, which was almost like this oasis.
Thank you.
Yes, I found that terribly interesting because, sustainability and
off the grid.
That's right, and I suppose where the Earthship part I connected to was, building something where you're not going to incur a large amount of debt, because obviously monetary systems is a massive theme for 2017 and probably going forward. Broken the shackles of that aforementioned police state or a government that wants to maintain its control of the people. So I suppose that's one of the things I took away from the movie. But terribly interesting film, and quite shocking in the way it portrays the society of that time in the film. The people almost desensitized to the day-to-day violence. I mean, we're seeing violence in cities all around the world now.
And people already getting used to the militarization of the police force in America.
Yeah, and over the top massive security to clamp down on terrorism.
So there's tons of kids now knowing nothing about the post 9/11 world. So
that's it. And I suppose that the character played by Clive Owen, he's portrayed as someone who's basically depressed, isn't he? He's smoking, he's drinking, and he's kind of lost that light in his eyes. It reminded me of that Pink Floyd song, Now that I Look Into Your Eyes. It's like two black holes in the sky. So yeah, mental health is going to be a massive issue going forward. Yeah, the way the guy filmed is quite interesting as well. He managed to create a very bleak atmosphere of the urban environments. I mean, it was incredibly dull, and it reminded me of that song Fade to Grey. So you've had a colourful, and then it's like the vibrancy is gone from the cities and the people, and you've got this overwhelming grey. Is one of the things I think he brilliantly portrays in the film.
Yeah.
Keep going.
Yeah.
So to summarise, Dan, do you think Earthships in general have a place for the, as like a preparatory tool for this possible outcome, and how likely do you think a society like that is possible? And it's set in 2027, it's only 10 years away, but do you think a society like that is possible given what you've seen in the last 10 years?
Well, I think anything's possible, and I don't think the outlook's probably not that positive. So in order, as you're saying, to reduce debt and have the skill set or actually have it in place to live off the grid and away from the urban environment, I think our ships definitely have a place.
Well, it's just a different skill base to what they're teaching the kids now. We haven't even touched on education, but maybe rather than learning about economics and sales techniques and things that go around consumption of goods, maybe we should be learning about food and shelter and mental health and basically how to treat one another a little bit better than we currently are.
Yeah, but this is, I don't think the society wants to teach people. They want them. They'll hang on until the end, I think.
Which is why I think this film is great, because it shows what the end is like, and it maybe might wake up some punters to the time to actually create action is now. The time to put pressure on governments is now, while you still can. All right, thank you, Dan, and thanks for the interview.